I have taken live.
Can I start now?
Yes, please.
Good evening, participants. Thank you for joining Shield Connect page. And today we have a speaker from Delhi, Dr. Nisha Bhatnagar. And today our speech, ma'am, will take on breastfeeding and COVID-19 benefits and challenges. So let me take to our page Shield Connect, and then I will give a quick intro of madam, and then we will start with the session. So let me share my screen 1 minute. So this is our page shieldconnect.in, where you can see various sections are available. The first section is the blog section. So you can see all the blogs written by the eminent speakers and doctors. And you can go through the page. We have a very new topics like the zinc and mucormycosis, probiotics in irritable bowel syndrome, then COVID-related blogs. And there is a webinar section where you can see upcoming webinars and past webinars. So in upcoming webinars, you can see all the webinars which are scheduled in this month, who is going to take and what time and date, everything you can see. And when you click on see more, you can enter the webinar. So like today's webinar, you can see it is available on Shield Connect, as well as it is also live on YouTube. And in the comment section, participants, you can ask your questions and share your feedbacks, so that at the end of the session, we can have a interactive Q&A session with our today's speaker, Dr. Nisha Bhatnagar. And then there is a page of past webinar where you can see all the webinars conducted in past. Then we have a awareness page where we have three different pages. First is the immune booster page, where we have reintroduced Rhodiomyn Mu for immune respiratory immune booster. So all the blogs and videos are related to it in this page. Then second is the PCOS awareness page, where you can see all the topics related to PCOS. Covered by different doctors in various languages like Tamil, Hindi, Malayalam, Telugu. And there is a new page, COVID-19 awareness page, where we always update our page with recent blogs and videos related to COVID-19. Then there is our leader page, where you can see all the speakers, eminent speakers who are connected with our page. Then the last page is the special day page, where you can see various days are available. So like Mother's Day, if you go on Mother's Day page, you will able to find all the contents which are related to mother's happiness. So these are the page in our Shield Connect page. And let me introduce our today's speaker, Dr. Nisha Bhatnagar. Ma'am is MBBS MD in Obstetric and Gynecology, and ma'am is a medical director at Avaya Fertility and IVF Center in Delhi. So we welcome you, ma'am, on our page Shield Connect, and I will hand over the session to you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Nishan. Thank you so much for the providing me. First of all, I would like to thank Shield Connect for providing me this opportunity to share my thoughts on such an eminent platform. And I would like to say that Shield Connect is doing a wonderful job in spreading knowledge and enabling the right ideas and right thoughts to reach the right people. Thank you so much, and well done. So today, the topic we are going to discuss is breastfeeding during COVID-19, the benefits and challenges. Just a second, let me. Yeah, so we all know we are going through a crisis. The world is going through a crisis. The times are tough. And the main reason for worry is that we are not clear how things are progressing, what would be the situation in 6 months or a year or 2 years later. Sometimes we, when we hear about all the mutants coming, the one thing which I know about is that we have to learn to live with this virus. We have to learn to adapt to this virus. And once we accept this, the next important question is how to, like, you know, adjust our lives around this virus. And one of the most important part of that is breastfeeding. We have, since the beginning of 2020, when the WHO announced a new strain of coronavirus, the SARS-CoV-2, there were, like, you know, the whole world has been dominated by this COVID-19 pandemic. In 1 year later, there were approximately 85 million cases and resulting in more than 1.8 million deaths, which is, like, you know, huge number. During the same period, approximately 140 million births have been registered. And after this, there was a great dilemma. You know, this virus is it spreads so fast. There is such a strong tendency that even if you are in a room in less than 1 meter distance, there is a probability that you may catch the virus. Then we were worried about the possible need to discontinue the breastfeeding of infants of infected mother. So we all know that coronavirus is a single-stranded RNA, non-segmented enveloped virus, which causes illness ranging in severity from the common cold to severe and fatal illness. We all know that term coronavirus is derived from Latin word corona. We also know that past 2 decades, 2 other coronaviruses have caused severe respiratory illness. That's the SARS-CoV and the Middle East respiratory syndrome coronavirus. But this is the most serious one because of the severity or the fatality of the diseases, the severity of the illness it causes. Now, breastfeeding, you know, if we talk about the benefits of breastfeeding, I think we are very well aware of that. We know that breastfeeding provides the optimum source of nutrients for the neonates. We also know that it is the first strong shield against infection, but also it lays down the foundation for somatic and psychological bonding between the mother and the child. Now, during the current COVID-19 pandemic, although the guidelines of the relevant international and national agencies recommend breastfeeding by SARS-CoV-2 infected mothers, considerable insecurity persists in daily clinical practice regarding the safety of the infants and the perceived advantages and disadvantages of discontinuation of breastfeeding. Now, we all know that COVID-19 is a highly transmissible. Breastfeeding should be encouraged, but observing all appropriate safety measures for the mother and close contacts. To date, evidence on the risk of vertical transmission is limited. Breastfeeding has generally been accepted as the preferred nutrition for the infant of the infected mother. In breastfeeding, and the another benefit, which is, like, you know, it has been postulated that in breast milk from infected mothers, IgA antibodies against SARS-CoV-2 have been detected. So there is a possibility that mother who is producing those antibodies, she is passing those antibodies to the baby, to the infant who is taking the breastfeeding. It may account for reduced clinical impact of the disease in breastfed infants upon future viral exposure. So as of now, we should accept that there is a limited data. We don't have too much of information available, but whatever limited information we have, we are just trying to put that together. On one hand, we have this possibility that an infected mother may pass on this infection to the child. But on the other hand, there had the SARS-CoV-2 virus has still not been found in the breast milk, but antibodies have been formed. So this is postulated that the mother may be transmitting this antibodies to the baby for the future protection. Now, challenge. The risk of COVID-19 transmission during pregnancy and breastfeeding, this is the major challenge we are facing. Now, this is a review carried out by Elizabeth. Around 340 records were reviewed, 37 with breast milk samples and 303 without breast milk samples. The 37 articles with analyzed breast milk samples reported on 77 mothers who were breastfeeding their children. Among them, 19 of 77 children were confirmed COVID-19 cases based on RT-PCR assays, including 14 neonates and 5 older infants. 9 of these 68 analyzed breast milk samples from mothers with COVID-19 were positive for SARS-CoV-2 RNA of the exposed infants. 4 were positive and 2 were negative. Currently, there is no evidence of SARS-CoV-2 transmission through breast milk. Studies are needed with longer follow-up periods that collect data on infant feeding practices and on presence of viral presence in the breast milk. Now, this is a European Pediatric Association paper on the importance of continuing breastfeeding during coronavirus disease. In support of the World Health Organization statement, they say that although vertical maternal fetal transmission cannot be ruled out, several small studies of pregnant women infected with COVID-19 found no evidence of vertical transmission because no infant tested positive at birth. And it is likely that the source of severe acute respiratory syndrome in the neonates, upper respiratory tracts, or NSS are maternal in origin. That means during the process of birth, they are being infected, not via breast milk. There is no evidence to date to suggest the novel coronavirus can pass to infants through breast milk because the virus was not found in breast milk. This possibility cannot be completely ruled out because, again, as I said earlier, the data available are based on limited clinical experience only. Even if the virus is transmitted occasionally, the risk and benefits would have to be balanced because you have to assess the long-term risk if the mother is not breastfeeding to the baby. In certain countries, in certain situations, you know, the breast milk is the only source of nutrition to the baby. The mother may not be able to give a proper diet to the baby or may not be able to give those fancy milks or anything. So we have to analyze the whole situation. The data currently available shows that the clinical features of COVID-19 in children and infants are generally mild, and risk for viral transmission from mother to child are likely to be directly related to a COVID-19 infection affecting the respiratory tract of mothers. The potential risk for newborn seems to be minimal. I hope we all understand this very well. Now, again, the European Pediatric Association recommends that even if the, this is in support to this WHO statement. The WHO statement emphasizes the breast milk contains all the nutrients in appropriate proportion, essential for the healthy growth of infants who can benefit from breastfeeding, also from mothers with COVID-19 infection confirmed or suspected. Breastfeeding guarantees many health benefits for both the mother and infant, and it is recognized the ideal food for children in the first 6 months of life, constituting a primary form of promoting the child's health and development. Breast milk is perfectly adjusted to the infant's nutrition requirements. We know these are the benefits and growth because it contains all the nutrients an infant needs. It enhances the immature immune system of the infant, and it strengthens defense mechanism against infections and the other agents throughout the breastfeeding period. According to WHO, mothers with COVID-19 or suspected COVID-19 can breastfeed their babies as long as they take appropriate precautions. Breast milk encloses various antimicrobial substances, anti-inflammatory components, and factors that promote the development of immune system and reduce the occurrence of respiratory tract infections. Again, very important. In the Journal of Pediatrics in 2020, this is the WHO's statement. Although in very few cases, now this is the Journal of Maternal, Fetal, and Neonatal Medicine, the American Journal of Paediatrics. The article was published in 2020. For the challenges on breastfeeding the COVID-19 positive mothers. Very few cases SARS-CoV RNA has been detected in breast milk. RT-PCR has not been validated for viral detection in breast milk. While the detection of RNA does not necessarily imply transmissibility, these cases, although mothers reportedly were using respiratory and hand hygiene, the contamination of breast milk samples by respiratory secretions cannot be ruled out. We are not sure whether it was the breast milk or it was contaminated by the maternal secretions. On the other hand, protective antibodies against SARS-CoV-2 have been detected in human breast milk. We are coming back to the same point that it is more beneficial to feed the baby rather than stopping the breastfeeding. Again, the same article, Journal of Maternal, Fetal and Neonatal Medicine, horizontal transmission of the virus from the mother to her newborn through respiratory droplets during breastfeeding remains the main concern. It's not the breastfeed. It's the exposure of the droplet, of the maternal droplet to the baby. Data supporting the benefits of isolation of the neonates born to mothers with COVID-19 during the first days of life are limited, and whether separation minimizes the risk of transmission remains unproven, especially in the face of increased transmission in the community. Many authorities propose that the neonate should remain in a distance of approximately 2 meters for the mother. The mother, maybe the mother is breastfeeding the baby, but the baby needs to be breastfed and then kept at a distance of 2 meters from the mother. So there can be a barrier such as a transparent curtain, or there can be a, you know, there can be a person who's taking care of the baby during the whole time, but the baby comes to the mother for, you know, just for the duration of breastfeeding. WHO argues for kangaroo and skin-to-skin care. You know, it is still a dilemma we are going. So the benefit versus the risks we have to assess. CDC has altered its position statement using shared decision-making between mother and family in consultation with the healthcare providers about the risk and benefits of cohabiting. Many institutions have adopted this position. So what this says is that, just a second. I would say like most of the situations concerning with COVID-19, this is also applicable to breastfeeding, that you have to have a shared decision with the family, with the mother, what she wants to do, what are their means, how much of nutrition they can supply to the baby if the mother is not breastfeeding, are they capable of handling the, you know, taking proper care of the mother and the baby. If she's just breastfeeding and the baby is separated from the mother, somebody else is taking care of the baby. So all these points need to be discussed with the mother as well as the family. So this is some data from various different countries and their different takes. Some says that rooming in is allowed. Some say that you have to have a direct breastfeeding. We have to still assess where we stand in that. As for India, we allow the rooming in, we allow the breastfeeding. Our stand is that the breastfeeding should be continued then with respiratory and hand hygiene according to mother's wishes. No separation if the mother is severely ill and temporarily separated, expression of breast milk through breast pump using breast and pump hygiene. This is our stand. This is India. Although guidelines issued by countries with different level of wealth, neonatal mortality, level of crisis, preparedness, reported breastfeeding were reviewed, no major differences were found between patterns and similar guidelines were identified. Most countries, irrespective of geographic region, development or economic status, they comply with the WHO guideline, which says that separation of the neonate with double the burden of both human and maternal sources in a period with the exhaustion of the healthcare staff and global shortage of personal protective equipment. Mother and child separation becomes even more problematic as maternal COVID-19 negative testing remains a requirement for hospital discharge in most institutions. According to the literature, SARS-CoV-2 viral shedding can persist up to second week of symptoms. So mother may not come negative for a very long duration. The mother needs to be discharged and newborn should be home quarantined if possible after discussion with the family. Now, as far as the recent guidelines, almost universally support rooming in and direct breastfeeding of the newborns born to COVID-19 women. So as far as the available resources are concerned, the point of concerning the long-term impact of the nutrition on the baby, most of the people suggest that the mother should be kept in the same room with the baby. There has to be have a healthcare provider or another person which is taking care of the baby. The mother breastfeeds the baby, but she takes all the proper precautions. She takes all the necessary precautions and then takes care of the baby. There are some additional challenges impeding the implementation of rooming in, which have been encountered. First of all, most important is the infrastructure. You have to be taken, this needs to be taken in account. Women are hospitalized postpartum in COVID-19 designated wards with up to 4 COVID-19 infected adults in the same room. Under these circumstances, no rooming in of an unaffected neonate can be provided because there are 4 people. You know the scenarios, the problem of the resources we have. So here is the WHO recommendation. WHO recommends that mothers with suspected or confirmed COVID-19 cases should be encouraged to initiate or continue to breastfeed. Mothers should be counseled that the benefits of breastfeeding substantially outweigh the potential risk of transmission. Mothers and infants should be enabled to remain together while rooming in throughout the day and night and to practice skin-to-skin contact, including kangaroo mother care, especially immediately after birth and during establishment of breastfeeding, whether they or their infants have suspected or confirmed COVID-19. Now, the summary of breastfeeding recommendations. Vertical transmission through breast milk, it appears unlikely. It cannot be ruled out, however, but evaluation needs to be done. Breastfeeding of COVID-19 positive or suspected mothers, primary recommendations are that primarily they should be encouraged to directly breastfeed. They should be encouraged to express the breast milk. They should be encouraged to abstain from use of any breast milk during set infectious period. Primary recommendation is for non-specific, either direct breastfeeding or use of express breast milk. Both can be done. Primarily encouraged to make plan through shared decision making with parents. Use of express breast milk typically only if maternal or fetal status prevents direct breastfeeding. If the mother is severely ill, then direct breastfeeding cannot be done. Then you can express the milk and give to the baby. Recommendation of direct breastfeeding versus use of expressed breast milk based on presence or absence of symptoms. Minimum time, the patient is symptomatic or asymptomatic. Consider infant feeding through use of a healthy caretaker if the mother is symptomatic. Regarding breastfeeding, it is now better understood that COVID-19 is primarily transmitted through aerosols and that decontamination of surfaces is a vital part of infection prevention. Most articles found in our review, particularly those more recent, felt that vertical transmission through breast milk remains unlikely. Now, this is a great article by Madeline. It's a systematic evidence review. It says that while the decision-making ultimately lies with the parents and providers, we strongly encourage direct breastfeeding and cohabitation of the mother and newborn in the immediate postpartum period. While vertical transmission of COVID-19 is possible, it is a rare mechanism that at this time appears highly unlikely, and that paying attention to horizontal transmission is of critical importance. For this reason, we recommend the use of enhanced precaution such as surgical mask and good hand hygiene when engaging in SSC, as well as breast cleaning and the use of a dedicated pump while breastfeeding. Now, there are 3 options for the mothers with the COVID positive. One, option A, option B, option C. These 3 options should be discussed with the patient. Option A is direct breastfeeding, infant cared for by mother. There are no risk, but in these cases, the mother has to be asymptomatic and she doesn't have any acute symptoms like distress or she has fever or something. The infant may be positive. In these cases also, you can go for direct breastfeeding you have to establish breastfeeding right from the first postpartum period. In these cases, scenario 1, where the mother infant are rooming in, and scenario 2, where there's a safe distancing of 2 meters between mother and infant. If we say that the mother is positive, the baby is negative, but the mother is having no symptoms or nothing, then rooming in can be allowed. Mother can express the milk and give to the baby, or mother can even breastfeed directly by taking the precautions, by taking the hand hygiene, by wearing a double mask, by wearing cleaning the breast before feeding. Option B is the expressed human milk, and infant is cared by the healthcare provider or a caregiver. In these cases, there is a limited contact between mother and infant. There is a difficulty in, there's difficulty to manage these situations because there might not be availability of so many healthcare providers. Mother is symptomatic and she needs some kind of respiratory support. In these cases, this can be done. Again, safe distancing of 2 meter between mother and infant and or isolation of mother and infant until mother is no longer infectious. In these cases, the mother has to wear proper face mask. She has to clean the pump. She has to have a dedicated breast pump. She has to disinfect the outer surface of milk container, express the breast milk and then give to the baby. Option C is where there is no breastfeeding and mother's own milk is not provided. In this case also, maybe because of difficulty in establishing lactation or the mother is severely ill, the parents have to be informed. There are other substitutes which are like human donor milk or infant formula, which needs to be given to the baby. The isolation of mother and infant should be done till the mother is no longer infectious. This needs support continuity of human milk production by expressing by from other sources. The breastfeeding needs to be resumed as soon as the mother is non-infectious, and alternative sources also needs to be taken in account for. So these are the possible options. The mother's infant contact at birth. Mother should not be separated from her infant. Enable rooming in, early skin-to-skin contact, breastfeed should be done 1 hour of birth with appropriate infection prevention and control. Direct breastfeeding, mother has to wear a face mask, perform respiratory hygiene. She has to, cough or sneeze into tissue, dispose them. She has to wash her hands. She has to clean the chest and with soap and water. And if coughing, if she coughs, then she has to clean it. Then she has to disinfect the surfaces. The mother has to, and then she has to avoid coughing or sneezing while the baby is feeding. Third is expression of breast milk. Another option. Mother should be encouraged and supported to express milk. She has to have a dedicated breast pump. She has to wear the mask during the process. Again, the hand hygiene needs to be followed, and the other outer surfaces of the bottles and everything needs to be cleared, and proper cleaning before and after each use should be done. Feeding of expressed human milk from a donor. Again, human milk containers with gloves, disinfection process needs to be followed, and someone needs to feed expressed human milk to the infant. If none of this is possible, then you can have alternative sources of milk, like the powder milk or anything else. This is an infographic. Again, same way it is explained how the mother has to use a hand hygiene. She has to wear a mask. She has to take proper precautions while feeding. Again, we come back to the fact that we all know that breast milk protects infants from many illnesses and the best food for the infant. These are the hygiene precautions she has to use. With a high risk exposure, you have to inform breastfeeding mothers who work in settings with high risk of exposure. Talk to supervisor at work about limiting exposure to situations involving COVID-19 positive patient. You have to clean shared surfaces in lactation rooms. After coming home, you have to take off your clothes and everything. And the infant is high risk for COVID-19. Consider isolating from the infant while providing breast milk. Now again, how to manage the risk of infection in breastfeed infants. Room sharing and uninterrupted mother-infant proximity is recommended as an important factor for establishing good breastfeeding for mothers with COVID-19, as well as providing that specific and appropriate respiratory and skin hygiene measures are taken. You have to keep in mind that this is the European Pediatric Association. I think almost everyone is recommending that if the mother, there is no, as of now, we have not found the traces of virus, we have not found it in the breast milk, the more chances are during the process of birth and when the mother is feeding the baby, the chances of exposure are by coughing or sneezing or if she doesn't follow the hand hygiene. So these are the safety measures, essential advices for mothers and staff working in maternity and newborn services. The importance of continuing breastfeeding, these are European Pediatric Association guidelines. advice measures for breastfeeding mothers. You have to regularly practice respiratory hygiene. In case of respiratory symptoms, you have to wear a mask, you have to wash hands, routinely clean and disinfectant any surfaces. If severely ill with COVID-19 or COVID-19 is suspected, or in case of other complications that are obstacle to continue direct breastfeeding, express milk to safely provide breast milk to infants. You can, even if the condition is not very favorable, the mother is critically ill or she is not able to provide, you can take a short break. The baby can be fed on other milk or other toned milk or anything else, or the powdered milk for some duration of time, and then she can restart the breastfeeding after a gap. She can use donor milk through certified donor milk banking and advised measures for staff working in maternity and newborn services. We already discussed on that. They should be able to remain together, practice skin-to-skin contact and room in throughout the day and night, whether or not the mother or child has suspected probable or confirmed COVID-19, especially straight after birth during establishment of breastfeeding. These are the ICMR guidelines for management of pregnant women. During temporary separation, mothers who intend to breastfeed should be encouraged to express their breast milk to establish and maintain milk supply. If possible, a dedicated breast pump should be provided to the mother. Prior to expressing breast milk, mothers should practice hand hygiene. After each pumping session, all parts that come in contact with breast milk should be thoroughly washed, and the entire pump should be appropriately disinfected as per the instructions. This expressed milk should be fed to the newborn by a healthy caregiver. If a mother and newborn do room in, what do we mean by room in? Room in means that they both are staying in one room, but they are maintaining a distance of 2 meters. There is a curtain or something which is separating the mother and the baby, and there is a dedicated caregiver or a healthcare professional there to give milk to the baby. These are again FOXI guidelines. Some viral infections, though, like HIV and all, are known to be transmitted through breast milk. COVID-19 is not secreted as of now in the breast milk. It is the best source of nutrition and immunity for the infant, so we suggest that it should be given to the baby. The risks and benefits of breastfeeding, including the risk of holding the baby in close proximity. This is an important point. This needs to be discussed with the mother. For women wishing to be breastfeed, pregnant women should wash her hands before and after touching her baby. Mother should practice respiratory hygiene by wearing a mask. All surfaces should be kept clean. If a mother is confirmed with COVID-19 infection or who is asymptomatic and wishes expressing breast milk with a manual or electric breast pump, the mother should wash her hands before touching any pump and bottle and should follow recommendations for proper pump cleaning. Consider asking someone who is well to feed expressed milk to the baby. Where mothers are expressing breast milk in hospital, a dedicated breast pump should be used. If she is too unwell to breastfeed her baby due to COVID-19 or its complication, she can be supported to safely provide breast milk to her baby in a way possible and acceptable to her. Advice should include management of engorged breast when feeding has not been established and measures to enhance breastfeeding after the isolation period is completed. So determination of whether to keep individuals with known or suspected SARS-CoV infection and their infants together or separate, it is the most important part, and it should be shared decision-making. Healthcare practitioners should respect maternal autonomy in the medical decision-making process. You should not force your decision onto the mother. The mother has a right to choose. Decision-making around rooming in or separation should be free of any coercion, and facilities should implement policies that protect an individual's informed decision. For mothers with suspected or confirmed COVID-19, rooming in should be combined with safety measures to minimize the risk of transmission, like using a mask or of cloth face covering or hand hygiene. And mask or cloth face covering should not be placed on neonates or children younger than 2 years of age. While enabling rooming in is a key practice to encourage and support breastfeeding, there may be circumstances where temporary separation is appropriate for the well-being of the mother and the neonate. Decision about temporary separation should be made in accordance with the mother's wishes. Separation may be necessary for mothers who are too ill to care for their infants or who need high level of care. Separation may be necessary for neonates at higher risk for severe illness. Consideration for separation as an approach to reduce the risk of transmission from another with suspected or confirmed to her neonate is not necessary if the neonates test positive for COVID-19. If temporary separation is undertaken, mothers who intend to breastfeed should be supported and encouraged to express their breast milk to establish and maintain the milk supply. If possible, a dedicated breast pump should be provided to the mother. Breast milk provides, we know that breast milk provides protection against many illnesses, and there are few contraindications to breastfeeding. According to the CDC, breast milk is not likely to be a source of COVID-19. Again, I'm enforcing this, that it's not the breast milk. It's the transmission through the coughing, sneezing, or through the hand, which is the main reason. While breast milk samples occasionally test positive for COVID-19 genetic material, no replication-competent viruses has been detected. Therefore, suspected or confirmed maternal COVID-19 is not considered a contraindication to infant feeding with breast milk. Same recommendations by ACOG also. Safety measures if breastfeeding mother with suspected or confirmed needs to be, including hand hygiene and wearing a face mask. So, key points. In summary, SARS-CoV-2 is unlikely transmitted via human milk. A shared decision making on infant feeding is the preferred approach. Mothers can safely breastfeed with appropriate infection control measures. COVID-19 pandemic has raised questions on pregnant women and newborns management. It is unlikely transmitted via human milk. As I already said, all the WHO, UNICEF, Union of European Neonatal and Perinatal Societies, CDC, all highlight the well-established overall short and long-term immunological and psychosomatic benefits of breastfeeding for the diet. A shared decision-making on infant feeding is the preferred approach. Evidence on the risk of vertical transmission is limited. Breastfeeding has generally been accepted. Guidelines issued by most international agencies recommend rooming in and direct breastfeeding, and mothers can safely breastfeed with appropriate infection control measures. Strict measures of mother-infant separation and discontinuation of breastfeeding are to be avoided, regardless of a positive diagnosis and the intensity of symptoms. Unless the severity is of such a level that mother cannot take care of the infant, in these cases, expressed, fresh, unpasteurized breast milk should be provided for the baby. Thank you so much. I hope we could clear all the doubts.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving the information regarding breastfeeding, COVID era. And let us see if we have any query in the comment section. So there is one question. If the COVID infected mother is taking immunomodulators, can she breastfeed?
Yes. I think there is no harm in that also.
And is there any...
By immunomodulators, we mean most probably steroids. So yes. I think there is no harm in that.
And if the mother is vaccinated, is there any chance of any side effect?
Pardon?
If the mother is vaccinated and the child is getting breastfed on the same day, is there any chance of any side effect to the baby?
No. Rather, we say that vaccine is producing the antibodies. And we have said that the antibodies are sometimes passed in the breast milk. So we are actually passing the benefits to the baby. So I think that should be there. The recommendation is there to do that.
Cannot see any more questions. This was a good presentation.
Thank you so much, Nishant. Thank you. Yes, I would once again like to thank Shield Connect for giving me this opportunity and enhancing my knowledge also, because every time you want to present a topic, you have to go through a lot. You have to, there were certain things which I was also not clear, and I was very happy that I had this talk. So I could clear my doubts also. Thank you so much, Shield Connect, and thank you.